The shocking state of addiction in America hitting an unexpected age group, senior citizens. A Florida retirement community has become the epicenter of a record rise in heroin and other opioid overdoses, as seniors there are turning to harder drugs such as painkillers. The Sunshine State has seen a staggering, look at this, 900% increase in heroin deaths among senior citizens since 2010. Here to talk about this growing epidemic and how to curb this crisis is Melissa Larkin Skinner, Chief Clinical Officer at Centerstone, the Florida Community's Behavioral Hospital. Melissa, thanks for joining us this morning. I think a lot of our viewers will probably be surprised by this. Where is this epidemic coming from?
It's really born out of prescription pain pill. So prescription pain pills became a huge problem in Florida around 2008 all the way through 2009. And pills were basically being handed out like they were candy. But as far as the effects of senior citizens, you know, senior citizens have legitimate reasons for being prescribed pain pills.
Sure.
And so those are handed out. And the unfortunate thing about these pills is that they are addictive.
Indeed.
No one is immune to their addictive effects.
And have they become a gateway to harder drugs like heroin? I mean, I guess it wouldn't surprise me on the painkiller side if folks are trying to get relief. But what about heroin? Is there, are we seeing increases in dealership, obviously leading to that using?
We absolutely have. So Florida cracked down on the illegal pain pills or the pain pills that were being prescribed in illegal pain clinics. And what happened is a huge shift to people using heroin instead. Pills became less available. Heroin became more available and much cheaper than pills. And so people, once you're already addicted, you're going to keep trying to find that substance that you're addicted to.
Wow, incredible. So for folks who have parents or grandparents that they visit on occasion or maybe don't live with on a regular basis and aren't able to track, what are the warning signs? What should people be looking for in case their family member might be facing this?
They should definitely look for any change in behavior, any increase in falls or accidents that maybe they didn't see before. Any confusion, disorientation, anxiety, depression, things that weren't there before. And the big thing to remember is that unfortunately for seniors especially, we look at a lot of those things as part of aging. And so we don't always recognize that there could be other causes like addiction.
What are the practical steps that friends and family members can take? How can we help a loved one in this situation?
So one thing that we definitely always want to do is see if there's any history of addiction in our families and to be honest about that with our physicians. Being able to attend appointments with our loved ones and our friends that are seniors is really important so that we can share the information that maybe they won't share themselves. And also educating ourselves about the different medications that physicians prescribe. Not everyone knows that these drugs, these medications are addictive and can become unsafe because, you know, a respected professional is prescribing them. And so educating ourselves and then being able to say no. No, I don't want anything that could be addictive. I don't want to take that chance. What are my other options?
Sure. Well, Melissa Larkin Skinner, thanks for educating us on this topic and sounding the alarm on something. Certainly we don't want to see the most elderly amongst us facing this type of crisis. Thanks for joining us this morning.
You're welcome.